Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome back. We are on the final day of our research on Greengrass Isle for the Good Sleep Day week. Also run out the good camp set, so not sure if I want to buy another one just yet. It is going to be a lot if I do that. And I don't know that I really have the spare diamonds to justify it at this point, so we're gonna take a look at that, but starting off getting our sleep points, we've got 8,775, and I just noticed the sleep pass has a chip in it, like it's a debit or credit card. I wonder why they did that. That's an interesting little detail. Huh. Well, anyway, you know it's Monday, so we got the landscapers outside the window again. Hopefully, as before, you guys don't hear them. I've been trying to mess with my microphone settings so that, one, I sound better, and two, you guys don't hear everything around me. So hopefully it's working. We're on session 65. 7 hours and 49 minutes. You can tell I went to sleep a little late. Woke up a little late. 24 minutes to fall asleep. Man, I slept really hard right there. Good for me. It's probably why I feel so awake today. We got slumbering type sleep. Maybe we'll get a Blastoise. That would actually be pretty cool. I actually started playing Pokemon with Red and Blue back in the day when they released, and Charmander was my first Pokemon ever. Didn't really care much for the others, but oh, nice, and a Top Belly Dodrio. Yeah, I didn't really care too much for Bulbasaur and Squirtle back in the day, just whatever, but as I've gotten older, I have gotten more appreciation for both. I got another Blastoise and Venusaur. Got Dodrio, Squirtle, Doduo, Wartortle, and Cubone. Bunch of repeats, but not terrible. Got 3 new ones, so that's always good. And the game's probably gonna crash. Are you crashing on me? I see a Tyranitar down there. Not a Tyranitar, Larvitar. Well, it wouldn't be one of my videos if the game didn't crash at some point. Just a second. All right, we're back. Larvitar is still down there. I do have a Larvitar, but it is not great. Face rubbing sleep. So if this guy could be hungry, that'd be really good. Have that. There you are. Another Doduo. The flock came out in force today. The lazy lookout sleep. We got lookout sleep and lazy lookout sleep. That's when he's a little bit more tired. Top Belly Dodrio. 2,500 dream shards. Nice. 1-star and a 4-star. Thought about using my my luck incense last night before I went to sleep, but I ended up not doing it. I kind of wish I had now. Doduo's hungry, but I do have a really good Dodrio, so I'm not super concerned with getting another Doduo at this point. I did start on the Squirtle. I do still have my Great Biscuit, so I could maybe use that on the Squirtle. feel like I want to go for this Larvitar. Didn't get lucky there. Here's the tricky part. Do I use the Great Biscuit on Squirtle and then probably still need a Poke Biscuit for him? Or do I go ahead and use the Great Biscuit just to make sure we get Larvitar, or risk giving Larvitar two Poke Biscuits and him getting full? Fortunately, what I think would be the case, that I would try to feed him Poke Biscuits and he'll get full and I won't be able to get him today. So I think I'm going to go ahead and use the Great Biscuit on him, and we'll, next time we see that Squirtle, give that the premium biscuit. Or the bonus biscuit. Keep calling it a premium biscuit and it is not premium. That is what we're going to do. Not I think. Definitely going to switch this to Larvitar. I'm pretty sure Tyranitar is a top tier Pokemon, so people will definitely be happy for the Larvitar candy. 1500 research XP. Poke Biscuit and an energy pillow I could have used yesterday. 1652 dream shards. Not bad. Level 8, that's good. Naughty nature. Nature's great. Got warming ginger, soybeans, and sausage. Not fantastic. Greedy and Finder, inventory up, both are fantastic at lower levels, so this could be a Larvitar we use for a while. At least until we find a better one. This is actually pretty good. Speed of help up and main skill chance down. While main skill chance down is not ideal with this Pokemon specifically, in my opinion, I would like to see charge energy popping more frequently with him. It's not the worst nature. Definitely use him until we find a better one, or her, until we find a better one. It's actually a pretty solid Larvitar. Cool. I did get to Master 6, so that was a Master 6 research. Master 6 research means all Doduos. And now, this week, I'm going to pick a different island. I kind of want to change the scenery. We've been on green grass for a while. I'm kind of ready for something new. And I have a feeling, and it could be completely wrong, it's just me on a wild theory. I have a feeling that for the Halloween event, Alp Hollow is going to be significant in some way. So I think that's where we're going to go, because I want to try to build up the area bonus there. But for the week, we've got Master 6, Final Strength 356,693, Gains from Berries 239,521, and Gains from Cooking 117,172. Even though they were all good, my Gains from Cooking were not as good as they could have been, because I did skip a few meals, and we didn't get any extra tasty all week. Yeah, I knew an A was coming. I knew I wasn't going to get S because Saturday, my phone dying. And then, Monday, where I had a really short sleep day. So, that's to be expected. We are almost halfway done with green grass. I'm definitely going Taup Hollow. I know it's going to be more difficult. Best I've ever gotten was Ultra 2, and I think I only spent a week there. But there are a lot of new area data. All right, whatever. Salads, okay. That's going to be very interesting. I don't know what the best salad is going to be for this accent in particular. What can we do? 92% sleep energy recovered and 92 XP gained from last night's sleep. Go ahead and collect from everybody. Ingredients. We may just do a quick salad. Not a quick one. But I may just go with a recipe I've already unlocked if I have the ingredients for it today. And then look into some more salads. But before we do that, no new news. Let's collect our research. I'm looking at the list of salads. 42 reports today. One, two, three, four. Oh, no high score, but I will take four ingredient tickets. I do have a bigger pot than I did last time. If I could get my hands on someone bringing in a decent supply of mushrooms, I could actually make a really good mushroom salad, but I don't think that's going to happen. I don't think I have anybody close enough to level 30 yet to be able to bring in mushrooms. So I don't have anybody bringing in leeks either. Honestly, funny enough, I think the best salad I can make is still the disgusting contrary chocolate meat salad. Where's it at? Yeah, I think this might be the salad we focus on this week, because it does have the... I'm going to go back over this after this episode and double check everything, because I don't want to sit here and bore you with an hour and a half of me scrolling through Pokemon. But we're going to do the Heatwave Tofu up first. Then I'm going to figure out what we can do off screen, so I'm not guys with that. 40 ingredients. I thought I only had 33. Oh, I think that's because I did get a metronome trigger last night from Togepi, and it landed on the increased pot space, but I didn't feed dinner because we had just breached Master 6 and there was no way to get to Master 7, so I didn't even waste the ingredients. I figured I'd save them for today. So I guess that carried over from last night. No, it's not lunch, it's breakfast. Barely snuck that breakfast in, apparently. Not quite basic 2. That's all right. So Leppa, Figgy, and Citrus, which are always the same for Talpalo. So I do have a team semi set up for this. It's been a while since I set this team up, but I think I had it set up. Energizing Cheer is good. Okay, so I set this team up to have at least 2 berry specialists for the berries that this Snorlax likes. So we've got Cubone for the Figgy berries. Charge Energy S, Inventory Up L is really good. We might actually put some candies into this team. Finish looking at this. Quirky Nature with no effect, so that's not terrible. Energy Recovery bonus would actually be very good to have on this team for anybody with a nature that is energy recovery lowering. This might be my priority to level up on this team. We've got Cyndaquil with the Leppa berries, Charge Strength, Helping Speed S, and Ingredient Finder, which I don't really care for Ingredient Finder, so I'm not super concerned with getting Cyndaquil to... may evolve it, though. That will make it significantly faster and level up the main skill. Speed of Help, Energy Recovery. Yeah, so that Cubone's sub-skill would actually help this Cyndaquil. We may do that. I think we're going to power up Cubone, evolve Cyndaquil. Slowpoke we may swap out on the team. I think I had him just as a placeholder. Gains up, main skill chance down. Yeah, that's really bad. I mean, we want someone, when you got an energizing Pokemon, we want them to proc often. We definitely don't want to decrease the amount of proc. Put Charmeleon on the team because he does have the Lepaberries, which is favored, but he's a solid ingredient gatherer outside of his nature. But even still, he generally brings back plenty. She generally brings back plenty of sausage. So I don't know if I want to focus on trying to evolve it, but I may at least get it to level 25, the helping speed increase. Butterfree, always a solid pick. I throw it on the team all the time just because it has really good, the first two sub skills are really good for me, and having ingredient magnet level 4 is always nice for extra ingredients. But if we're going to be focusing on the contrary chocolate meat salad, we need to get something that is going to be more consistent, bringing in cacao. I do know for sure we're going to swap out Slowpoke. I did not mean to long press on that. So, head and sort. Who can bring me some cacao at a... it's not going to be Eevee. I think Bayleaf was actually the only one that really... Let's see. No. Nope. I already know that's a no. I don't know why I clicked on it. Nope. I think Bayleaf is really my only choice. Yeah. Even though it's not an ingredient specialist, I don't have an ingredient specialist for cacao. Maybe contrary chocolate meat salad is not going to be best on this team. What are you two bringing me? Ginger. Maybe focusing on something with ginger might be a bit easier. The problem is there's not really anything. If I had somebody that could bring in leeks, that'd be perfect. But all I'm seeing is the overheat ginger salad, which is significantly better than the Heatwave Tofu Salad, but it requires 35 pot space, and I think I only have 33, so that's not gonna work either. But yeah, we're kind of in a bad spot for these salads. We really just don't have much of anything super great. Can't consistently get the soothing cacao. Contrary chocolate meat salad would be the best that we could do right now. So we may just have a Bayleaf on the team and I really think that's our best choice, is just put Bayleaf on the team and hope that between the two ingredient magnet players on the team, we get a decent number of cacao. We're just not in a great spot for salads at the moment. Evolves at level 21 and we want to get it to level 25. So it's going to take a lot of candies. Yeah, that only gets it to level 17. How many handy candies do I have? I have a decent amount. Not enough. Get them back pretty easily. So let's use 20 of them for now. Every single one of them. gets us to level 20. Not terrible. That's double the level, so that's, it's something. And want to evolve the Cyndaquil. We want to get a Quilava. Quilava? Yeah. There we go. Got us down to 41 minutes even, so that's pretty good. And a level 2 charge strength S. So if we can get that skill to proc a few times, that will help throughout the week as well. Can we do anything? Help main skill chance down. Good. But let's just go ahead and power up. Let's do everything we can to beef up this team because we're gonna need it for this location. Except for Charmeleon. I don't know if I really want to put anything into Charmeleon. Just because of its nature. But that helping speed S is really good. Two more handy candies. We can get that level 25 substance. Five more. See if that's just barely not enough. One more should be enough, hopefully. No. I should have used the second one. I knew it too. Should have gone with my gut. All right, now we have enough to get to level 25. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Helping speed S. 44 minutes and 15 seconds with Charmeleon now. Butterfree, you know what? I'm always willing to drop candies into this Butterfree. It's so easy to level up and evolve another one. But I don't even think I've seen a Caterpie, really, since I got this shiny one. I don't know. That's weird. That's the team we're rocking for right now. But I said we're going to do everything to power them up as much as we can. Let's go ahead and get this Quilava to level 12. ...145% energy. I love that number. That's great. Only everybody else look like that. That Quilava is going to be bringing in a lot today. Perfectly fine with me because we're definitely going to need it. That's the team we're looking at. We've got Cubone, Quilava, Bayleaf, Charmeleon, and Butterfree. Total of 3,977 RP. I think... I think the recommendation for Top Hollow is 4,000, so being pretty close to it is not bad. And by the end of the week, we should be well above it. Berries left behind. That's fine. We did get a medal. I forgot about that. Number of flying-type Pokemon studied. 12 of them were in that last research. Another energy pillow. That's good. I may drop one of those on Butterfree later. Just to, why do I feel like I missed something? I did. That's right. I wanted to get you to level 25 for that energy recovery bonus. I don't know if I have the handy candies to do it. That's 60 Cubone candies. Is it enough? I don't know. You know what? Whatever, we're gonna try. We're gonna get as close as we can to level 25 if we don't hit 25. Didn't come close to 25. But we are that much closer, so hopefully we'll hit it by Wednesday instead of Saturday. And it puts us at 4,001 RP for the week, so I'll take that. And we'll just have to see how it goes. And hopefully I'm right that the Halloween event will take place. We'll have something to do with Taup Hollow, and we will have our team and everything set up and ready to go for the event, if that is the case. But have to wait and see. But that's all I've got for now. So thanks for watching the video. Hit the like button if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to see more. And until next time, later, dudes.